Hello students, in the last mathematics session we learnt about the conversion of decimals to rationals, and at the end we observed that terminating decimals, if you convert into rationals, their denominators are of the form 2 multiples into 5 multiples. And now in this class we are going to convert the rational numbers into decimals. I have few examples on the board, and I am going to convert these rational numbers into decimals, and at the end I will observe all those conversions, and I am going to generalize a statement which type of rationals are terminating and which type of rationals are non-terminating. Have a look at this. The first one is what? 25/2. See, you all already learnt about this conversion. Converting a rational number or a fraction into decimal is possible just by the division process, right? And what I have here? 25/2. So converting this 25/2 into decimal is just nothing but dividing the number 25 with 2, right? You need to do the division. See, 2 1s are is 2, and you left with 5, and then 2 2s is 4, then 5 minus 4 is 1, since 1 is the remainder. And we are going to convert it into decimal form. You need to use a decimal point here along with a 0 there. And now 2 5s is 10, then it leaves a remainder 0. So at the end, the decimal representation for this 25/2 is 12.5. See, you all already know it, the way of converting a rational number into decimals using division process. And now have a look how to convert it into decimal without using this division process. And now see, I have the number 25/2, right? And I wish to convert it into the decimal form. See, already we know that the conversion of decimals from rationals to decimals and decimal to rational is very easy if the denominators are powers of 10. For suppose, if I have a number like 7/10, how to represent it into decimal form? If it is 7/10, easily we can write it like 0.7. And for suppose, if I have a number like 132/100, and I will write it like 1.32. We know that we need to place the decimal point before the number of digits as the number of zeros in the denominator, as the power of 10 in the denominator, right? So if we have denominator as power of 10, then it is easy for us to convert it into the decimal form, right? So now look at the number 25/2, where the denominator is 2. See, if I need to check whether there is any possibility to make the denominator as power of 10 or not. If there is a possibility to make the denominator as a power of 10, I do in that process to convert it into decimals without this division process, right? See, how to convert this denominator 2 into the power of 10? We know that by the fundamental theorem of arithmetics, 10 is a combination of 2 and 5. 10 is equals to 2 into 5. So to make a 10, we need 1, 2 and 1, 5. But here what we have? I have 1, 2 only. So I need one more 5 to make it as 10, right? So I need one more 5. That's why I just multiplied this 25/10, both numerator and denominator, with 5. See, is it right? Nothing will happen if you multiply both numerator and denominator. Just to get 10 in the denominator, I do this by multiplying both numerator and denominator with 5. Now look here. See, the numerator is what? 25 into 5. And denominator is what? 2 into 5. Yeah. What you say about the numerator? 25 into 5 is nothing but 125, whereas the denominator 2 into 5 is nothing but 10. And now 125/10. Look there, this is 10. 10^1. 10 is there in the denominator. So you need to use the decimal point before one digit of the numerator, and that conversion is just nothing but 12.5. So this is the way of converting a rational number into decimal using division process, and this is the way of converting a rational number into decimal without actual division. And now here we need to use this without actual division process for your examination purpose, right? See, there are some rational numbers where this type of conversion is not possible. where there is no chance to convert the denominator as power of 10, then in those cases, it is must to move with the division process, right? So at the end, if you take 25 by 2, its decimal representation is what? 12.5, right? And now, coming to the next rational number, what I have on the board, it is 13 divided by 2 into 5 square. See, if you look this 13 divided by 2 into 5 square, see, 1, 2 is there, 2 5s are there. My task is converting that rational number into decimal. As I mentioned you here, see, if the denominator is power of 10, if the denominator contains 10 or 100 or 1000 like that, then it is easy for us to convert it into decimal without using actual division process. See, 10 is a combination of 2s and 5. Here if you look, the denominator contains only 2s and 5s. But there are 2 5s along with 1 2. So if I have one more 2 in the denominator, I will combine 2 with 5 as 10. Okay, see, to make a 10, I need equal number of 2s and equal number of 5s in the denominator. But here I have only 1 2 and 2 5s. So to make equal number of 2s and 5s, what I have to do? See, we have only 1 2, right? So I need to multiply with one more 2. So now this is 13 divided by 2 into 5 square. I have a possibility to use division process, but I am moving without division process to convert it into decimals. So to make equal number of 5s and 2s in denominator, I need to multiply with 2, both numerator and denominator. And now, see, the numerator is 13 into 2, whereas the denominator is 2 into 2 is 2 square into 5 square. And now, the numerator is 26, whereas the denominator, 2 square into 5 square. See, 2 into 5 square, which is nothing but 10 square. And 10 square is 100. So, 26 divided by 100. There are two zeros in the denominator. So, you need to use the decimal point before two digits of the numerator. And I will write it like 0.26. Have a look at this. The given rational number is what? 13 divided by 2 into 5 square. And the corresponding decimal representation is what? 0.26. How I do? I did it by using, see, without using division process, right? And now, coming to the third decimal, what I have on the board, it is 1 by 3. Okay? Here, this 13 divided by 2 into 5 square is what? 0.26. Now, we need to look about this 1 by 3. Yeah. See, 1 by 3. To convert it into decimal, we have two methods. One using division, other one without using division. So without using division, if you wish to convert a rational number into decimal, we need to get some powers of 10 in the denominator. But what is there here in the denominator? Just 3 is there in the denominator, so it is not possible to make 3 as a power of 10. See, multiply 3 with any number as your choice, but you won't get a power of 10 with that 3, right? So it is somewhat not possible to make the denominator as power of 10. Then in those cases, it is not possible to convert this 1 by 3 into decimal form without using division process. There must I need to move with the division process. So see, to convert it into decimal, I need to divide 1 with 3. So dividing 1 with 3, so this is a smaller number. So we use 1 0 here and then 0 point in the quotient, right? So 10 and 3. So 3 3s is 9. 10 minus 9 is 1. I have already decimal point here. So use one more 0. And 3 3s is 10. 9 9. 3 3s is 9 and 10 minus 9 is 1. So already have decimal point. Use one more 0. And like this, if you continue, this 1 by 3 is nothing but 0.333 and so on. That 0.333 and so on is nothing but what? 0.3 bar. Already we discussed it in the previous class, converting from decimal to rational, and now here it is from rational to decimal. How I did this? I did it by using division process. Why I am moving with this division process? Because it is not possible to convert it into decimal without division process, because the denominator not contains 2s and 5s. If there is any 2 or if there is any 5, then it is easy for us to multiply the denominator with some more 2s and some more 5s to make a power of 10. Okay, since 10 is a combination of 2 and 5. But here what I have? 3. So we are unable to convert the denominator 3 into a power of 10. Then in that case, it is not possible to convert it into decimal without division. So for sure, we need to move with the division. That's what I did here. And now, this 1 by 3 is just nothing but what? 0.3 bar. Have a look at this. And now, the next decimal, what I have here, it is 21 divided by 75. 21 divided by 75. Right. How to do it? Is there any possibility to convert it into decimal without division? For that, you need to check the prime factors involved in the denominator. So I will rewrite it like this. 21 divided by 3 into 5 square. Have a look at this. Yeah. See, 75 is 3 into 5 square. In the denominator, there are 2 5s. To get the power of 10, what I do? To get the power of 10, I will multiply with 2 square. Because there are 2 5s, to get 10s, I will multiply with 2 square. But what about this 3? See, you may get 300 or you may get multiple of 3, but this is not possible to make the denominator completely as a power of 10. That's why, again, for this number, you need to move with the division process. Just a minute, right? This is 21 divided by 75. See, this 21 divided by 3 into 5 square is in p by q form, but not in simplest form. So for that, first of all, you need to convert it into simplest form. Then only you need to think about the conversion, right? See, how to convert it into simplest form? See, to convert it into simplest form, you need to check whether there are any factors related to the numerator and denominator. Denominator have 3, and numerator also have what? 3, because 21 is just nothing but 3 into 7. So write it as 3 into 7 and cancel out that 3. Then you left with 7 by 5 square. So directly if you look, see, it may give you certain confusion that there is no possibility to convert it into the decimal without division. But after making it into simplest form, now if you look, there are only 5s in the denominator, and now it is easy for us to convert it into decimal without division. So how to do? To convert it into decimal without division, we need to make powers of 10 in the denominator. We need to make equal number of 2s and 5s in the denominator. Because there are 2 5s here, I need to multiply with more 2 2s. So this is equals to 7 divided by 5 square into 2 square divided by 2 square. And now, look at the numerator and denominator. The numerator is 7 into 2 square, which is 28, and whereas the denominator is 5 square into 2 square. See, we know that 5 square into 2 square is 10 square, and that 10 square is nothing but 100. And 28 by 100 is nothing but 0.28, because there are 2 zeros in the denominator, I need to use decimal point before 2 digits. Now, at the end, the decimal representation for this 21 by 75 is 0.28. See, to check whether the decimal representation is possible without division or not, first of all, you need to convert the given decimal, given rational, into its simplest form. And then you need to check whether it is possible to make the denominator as power of 10 or not. So at the end, the decimal representation for this 21 by 75 is 0.28. Have a look at this. First, I converted into simplest form, 7 by 5 square. Then to make powers of 10, I multiplied with 2 square. And then this is 28 by 100, and the result is 0.28. So to decide whether the conversion is possible with division or without division, first of all, you need to express the given rational number into its simplest form. Then only you need to think it, right? And now, the conversion is what? 0.28. Okay, because the simplest form is there for this, and that simplest form is what? 7 by 5 square. Since the simplest form is 7 by 5 square, then its conversion is 0.28. And I have the last one more number, 5 by 11. The rational 5 by 11, and I need to convert it into decimal form. See, 5 by 11. See, there are no common factors for this 5 and 11. Itself, the 5 by 11 is in simplest form. So, to convert without division, we need to try to make powers of 10 in the denominator. See, in the denominator, there are no 2s,
there are no 5s, so it is somewhat impossible to make powers of 10 in the denominator with this 11. Multiply this 11 with any number as you wish, but you won't get power of 10, okay? So that's why to conversion of this rational number into decimal without division is difficult, is not possible. That's why I will move with the division process. So 5 when divided by 11. See, 5 is a smaller number, so use 0 here and 0 point in the quotient part. And now 11 fours is 44 and the subtraction results out 6. Already decimal, already point is there here, so you need to use one more 0, and this is 0. 11 5 is 55 and 60 minus 55 is again 5. Look there, again I got it here 5. See, since decimal point is there, use one more 0 here and again it is 50. That in the sense I need to use again 4 11 4s. And if you continue this division, you will get here 0.454545 and so on. And at the end, the decimal representation for this number 5 by 11 without division is not possible, and with division it is what? 0.4545 and so on, and I will represent it like this. At the end, this is 0.4545 and so on, or we may write it like 0.45 bar. At the end, if you look all these conversions from rational number to the decimal form, see, look at the denominators and look at the decimal representations. Among all these decimals, this 12.5 is a terminating decimal. Is it right? 12.5 is a terminating decimal. And this 0.26 is also a terminating decimal. And now this 0.3 is non-terminating. Okay. And what you say about this 0.28? This is also terminating. And then the last one, 0.45 bar, is non-terminating because the number of digits in the decimal part are infinite and the digits are continuously repeating, so we call it as non-terminating. Now my concentration is on terminating decimals and non-terminating decimals. Don't think about the repeating and the other things. See, just you pay your attention on the terminating decimals, their rational forms, non-terminating decimals and their rational forms. In particular, the denominators of the rational numbers. Here from the first example, the decimal is terminating. Look at the denominator, it contains only 2s. Whereas here, if you look at the denominator of this decimal, it contains 2 and 5s. Whereas here in the third case, the decimal representation is non-terminating, but here in the denominator, we don't have 2 and 5s. But for this example, it is terminating decimal, denominator contains only 5s. Here non-terminating, denominator contains no 2 and 5s. See what you observed with this complete discussion. See, if you observe it, if you have either 2s or 5s or both 2s and 5s in the denominator, then for us it is easy to make the denominator as power of 10 and it directly results out a terminating decimal. In all the other cases, if the denominator contains other than 2s and 5s, then it is not possible to convert it into the terminating form because it is not possible to make power of 10 in the denominator. Then at the end, what I am going to conclude you is, if I have a rational number in its simplest form, you need to look at the denominator. If the denominator contains only powers of 2 or powers of 5 or both powers of 2 and 5, then it is easy for us to convert it into terminating decimal. In all the other cases, it is not possible to convert into terminating decimal. And now I am going to generalize the statement, right? See, let us look at the slide on your screen. It is a general statement which gives an idea to decide whether a rational number is terminating or non-terminating just by observing the denominator. See, the statement gives us, let x is equals to p by q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where n and m are non-negative integers. Then x has a decimal expansion which terminates. That it means if the denominator is of the format 2 power n into 5 power m, then the decimal representation is terminating or otherwise it is non-terminating.
let us look at few examples, and we need to decide which of these rational numbers are terminating and which of these are non-terminating just by observing the denominator. And it is possible just by the general statement what we observed on the screen. See, we have a decimal number. Let the decimal number as some x. See, the decimal number, its rational representation is p by q. I have a decimal x whose rational representation is p by q. Now you need to concentrate on this denominator q. See, if the q is of the format 2 power n into 5 power m, then this x is a terminating decimal, or otherwise this x is non-terminating. See, the denominator q must be of the format 2 power n into 5 power m. See, try to understand it. The denominator contains only prime factors for the denominator as 2s and 5s. Okay, other than the 2 and 5, if you have any other number, it is not terminating. Okay, or sometimes that n or m may be 0. If for suppose if n is 0, what it happens? 2 power 0 is 1, the denominator contains only 5, no problem. Then in that case also, the decimal is terminating. If for suppose m is 0 in any case, here m 5 won't be there. We have only powers of 2 in the denominator. Then in that case also, we have a chance to convert it into terminating decimal by making denominator as power of 10. At the end, what to do? You need to concentrate on the denominator, whether it contains 2s or 5s or both. In these three cases, we say the decimal as terminating. In all the remaining cases, we say it as non-terminating. Look at the first example. This is 2 power 5 divided by 32. Just look at the denominator. Denominator is what here? 32. And that 32 is nothing but 2 power 5. We know it. That in the sense, denominator contains powers of 2. So, it is a terminating decimal, right? So, this is a terminating decimal. Whereas, coming to the second example here, what we have? This is 2 power 2, 5 power 7 and 7 power 5. See, there are 2s, there are 5s, but other than 2 and 5, we have some other factor, which is 7. If this 7 power 5 is not there, then we say it as terminating. But other than this 2 and 5, we have some other factors, prime factors, 7 in the denominator. So this is non-terminating. And now look at the third example. See, this is 229 divided by 343. See, look at the 343. Try to do prime factorization for the 343. See, that prime factorization indicates no 2s and no 5s in its prime factorization. Since we have no 2s and no 5s in the denominator, and for sure, it is non-terminating. To make it terminating, we need 2s and 5s. And look at the fourth example here, 23 divided by 125. What you say about the prime factorization of this 125? And for sure, it is 5 cubed. That means it contains only 5s. So other than that 5s, we don't have other prime factors. So we are able to convert it into terminating decimal as per the general statement. Now, look at the last example. Again, here the denominator contains only powers of 2 or powers of 5. 2 square into 5, it contains both powers of 2 and 5. We don't have other factors. So this is also a terminating decimal. So at the end, to say a decimal, a rational number, either as terminating or non-terminating, just it is enough to look at the denominator. No need to do actual division, no need to convert it into decimal form. See, just you look at the denominators and then search for the prime factors of 2 and 5. By this general statement, it is easy for us to say whether it is terminating or non-terminating. And at the end, this generalization is possible just with the help of fundamental theorem of arithmetics. See, fundamental theorem of arithmetics states us about the prime factorization process, and that prime factorization process at the end results out this beautiful one. And the next thing what we have to discuss is about irrational numbers. Why? Because we discussed about the integers in Euclid's division lemma and with fundamental theorem of arithmetics. And in the last class until now, we discussed about the rational numbers and their conversions into decimals. See, if you observe the last class, what we did? There we converted the decimals into rational form. See, there is a possibility to convert terminating decimals to rational numbers, non-terminating repeating decimals to rational numbers, but it is not possible to convert non-terminating, non-repeating decimals into rational numbers. That's we observed in the last class. And now we converted different rational numbers into decimals. See, if you check,
we converted every rational number into decimal, and all those decimal representations are either terminating or terminating, non-terminating, repeating. That in the sense, see, every rational number has either terminating or non-terminating repeating representation, as well as we convert, there is a possibility to convert only terminating and non-terminating repeating decimals into p by q form. At the end, what I am going to conclude you is, just look at the board, I have some decimal representations. See, 3.47. What is the decimal? We learnt it as a terminating decimal. This is terminating decimal, and there is a chance to convert this terminating decimal into p by q form. Already we did all these things in previous sessions. And now this is 13.58 bar. See what you say it. This is a non-terminating, because 58 is repeating, okay? Non-terminating but repeating decimal. So this is non-terminating and repeating decimal. And there is a chance to convert this non-terminating repeating decimal also into p by q form. Right? And now the next one. This is also non-terminating repeating decimal. Right? See, in particular, if you say this is pure repeating and this is mixed repeating, but at this case, just observe these two as non-terminating repeating decimals, and we have a chance to convert this non-terminating, non-repeating, see, repeating decimal also into p by q form. And now look at the fourth decimal, and this decimal is also non-terminating because the number of digits in the decimal part are infinite and the digits continuing like this. See, but we don't know exactly what will come after these three, because nothing is repeating here and nothing is, no pattern is observed here. So we don't know which comes after these three. That's why for this type of decimal, it is not possible to convert it into p by q form. So there is no rational representation for this decimal. And look at this. The next example, this is also a non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. See, the no decimal part is repeated here, and there is no any pattern involved here. So it is not possible to decide the next digit after the 7 here. So that in the sense, exactly we don't know the number of digits in the decimal part of this decimal. So this is also not in p by q form. At the end, if you observe, there are infinite number of decimals. And among all those decimals, there are some decimals which are not in p by q form. There are some decimals which are not possible to convert it into p by q form. All those decimals, since they are not in p by q form, and for sure, they are not rational numbers. And these two are not in p by q form. These type of decimals are not rationals. And there, we call these type of decimals as irrational numbers, because they are not rational numbers. Let us look at the slide on your screen. It contains few questions related to the conversion of rational number to the decimal and decimal to the rational. See, these questions involve with the concepts what we discussed in this class, and you just try to solve these questions. Thank you.